So the A7C II is coming this year, says rumors floating around the internet. If you're looking for a great camera in 2023 to take on trips and pretty much do everything, the A7C II will most likely be that camera. Let's break down what we'll be seeing in this camera coming this year. First, the sensor. This will be the same sensor as the A7 IV, and I am 100% sure of that, as the A7C was just the A7 III, they even rhyme. So we'll be seeing a 33 megapixel full frame CMOS backside illuminated sensor. Honestly, it's a great sensor, it does a good job. I did make a video about how bad the A7 IV is, so if you wanna watch that and kind of understand the price per what you get, I think this will kind of fix that because you'll kind of be expecting what the A7C is versus what the A7 IV was supposed to be or is. We're going to for sure see the same low light specifications as we had in the A7 IV also. Autofocus. It should have the same autofocus specifications as the A7 IV, but this one comes with an asterisk as we may see the implementation of the A7 R5 autofocus, AI autofocus, which would be awesome. I think they will just put that in every camera going forward, but with the A7 C2 being the type of camera that it is, we'll have to just wait and see. Next, we have the EVF. This is where things differ a little bit from most sources, and some on the internet are saying that they will stay with the EVF from the first version, which wasn't all that great by today's standards. But what do you expect for a pocketable camera in 2023? I don't think they're going to rewrite the book here and give you the same as the A1 or the A7S3, but they might be able to implement a better EVF, maybe the same EVF that's in the A7 IV also. If I was a betting man, I would say that we're gonna see the same EVF as Mark I, but we'll have to just wait and see. For video specs, we'll get the same specs as the A7 IV, so that means 4K 60 with a slight crop and 1080p 120 full frame. Plus we will get the 10-bit 422 codecs and S-Cine tone with this camera, finally. Ibis is the last thing that I think will be changed. With the extra stop of Ibis in the A7 R5, I'm sure they will implement that into every new camera going forward, as the competitors have really stepped up their game and dropped their prices, making this a harder choice in 2023, just to be honest. And that brings us to price. I don't think they can go much above $2,000 with this camera, as like I stated before, the competition has cameras that are cheaper with higher specs at this point. And maybe Sony's just banking on the full frame aspect grabbing people's attention. But I think that mindset is becoming more and more antiquated, as Super 35 sensors are great producers these days. But only time will tell on these. So what do you think? Do you think these specs are correct and this will be close to what comes out this year pertaining to the A7 C2? Or it will be wildly different and be something crazy that Sony cooks up in their Sony lab making cool cameras and such. So leave me a comment down below, letting me know what you think. All right, that's all I have. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you got something out of this. Leave a thumbs up if you like to. Maybe hit that subscribe button, no pressure. And we'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks, cheers.